Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is John and I will start this video with an announcement. From now on, my videos will be in English so more people can understand what's going on in these videos. Don't worry, I will try or I will find a way to have subtitles at captions like CCs in Romanian. So my Romanian viewers can also understand what's going on here. So moving on to what we do on this channel. Today I'm gonna have three reviews in one video because they're all connected. So it's gonna be a hot air soldering station, flux for the soldering, and this thermal mat that I'm gonna use to protect my desk so I don't burn it. And not only the desk, so I don't burn the house down. The soldering station, this I got from AliExpress, the flux as well, but I didn't want to wait one more month for the mat to arrive, so I bought one locally at a decent price for my country. So let's get close to, first of all, the soldering station. Okay, so we have the unit, the gun, you can see here. This mount for the gun is detachable and you can mount it on this side. It has the holes here. The cable is detachable, as well as the main plug is detachable, the cable for the main plug. You can turn it on from here, the power. You have here temperature up and down, so you can set the device's temperature. Usually it's gonna be around 300 something. If you have unleaded, you're gonna go. If you have unleaded flux, you're gonna go somewhere around here, 343. If you have leaded flux, older flux, you're gonna go around 315, 316 degrees. This is the airflow. So, this is the lowest. That's how it sounds. And we crank it up. This is the max. And that's how it sounds. Okay, you put it back in the cradle and it's gonna drop temperature. We have three different nozzle attachments. Smallest one, a medium one, and this is the biggest one. The fact that the cables, okay, let me shut it down. The fact that the cables are detachable is a big plus, if you ask me. This is the plug for the gun. Goes here, you can screw it so it doesn't go out when you are working. The fact that they are detachable is a big plus, if you ask me, because if anything breaks, you can just replace the broken part easily without taking the main unit apart. And storage is a big plus. You can store it much more easier when you have detachable cables, because you can make it fit in a smaller space. So yeah, that's a big plus if you ask me. The back of the unit, it's even simpler. You have the mains plug, like the same as you have on your computer, a desktop computer. The fuse here, you can open this and swap the fuse easily. And a jack for earth. I bought it with an EU plug. It has a brushless fan inside the gun. They say the amount of wind is 120 liters per meter, the range, the temperature range is between 100, let's check, yep, 100, and 4, they say 450, but here is 480. Maybe it just shows 480 degrees on the display, but actually it's 450, the maximum. Discharge feature, LED indicator light, the noise, they say it's under 45 decibels, and it weighs 1.3 kilograms. The length of the handle is 120 centimeters. This would be the description of this hot air soldering station. So now, let's try to use it and see what happens. Next, we have the mat, the thermal mat. It said it can support up to 500 degrees. You have storage spaces, this one and this one, and the round one are magnetic. You can put your tools up there. You have also three storage spaces that have lids, so you don't lose anything if this goes like flying, but you're gonna lose these and these, and yeah, okay. Anyway, so yeah, it's designed for smaller pieces like phones and stuff, but you can make it work for a bit bigger boards if you want. So if you ask me, for the price, it's a quite nice deal. You have here numbered slots for screws. You have slotted spaces here so you can store, and here so you can store your drivers. Here as well, so you can store your driver bits. Next we have the Flux. It's a type RMA 223, 10 cc's, made in China. Flux from Amtech. It says advanced SMT solder products. I don't know. Looks okay. I hope it's good. We have the plungers here, 5 plungers and 10 needles. So we have 10 of these. I don't know why 10 of these and 5 plungers, but anyway, okay, that's the focus point. All right, so maybe these get plugged quickly, maybe. Okay, let's open one. Nothing special, you just pull this plug. Then we take this off, I think. Yep, just this. This other red thing stays here, and I do believe you have to. Yep, think so. Flux is coming out, as you can see. That's it. Okay, so we're gonna use this one. Okay, let's take the plunger out. I think we're gonna keep it like this until it gets a bit lower in the syringe, so we can leave it in. Okay. Yep, we forgot the needle. You have to install the needle as well. This is how it looks with the needle. Alright, this doesn't want to work, so I'm gonna put the Flux like this here, and see what happens. Let's see, gonna go up with the airflow. Doesn't seem like it's melting. Let's get the tweezers and see if it moves. Yep. And as easy as that, we got the chip off the board. And now let's see if we can stick it back as easy as we got it out.
crap. Okay. Let's see. Yep. It's on there. So yeah, we did a pretty good job of that. Now let's see another thing. Let's see if we can get this chip out. Okay, leave the flux here. Alright. Is it moving? Not yet. Nope. Let's give it more airflow. Yep, it's moving. Grab the chip. We have the chip. As easy as that, we removed the small chip with so many legs. Let's see, can we put it back? Well, yep. Okay, yeah, we leave this board alone for now. Now we take another board, this board. I want to see if I can get a RAM chip off this board. And we're gonna choose which one. 1, 2, 3, 4, this one. The third one. Okay. This side as well. That's enough. Let's see now. Yeah, that's gonna be a bit sketchy, so I'm gonna take it from the other side. Well, I like this flux, to be honest. The mat is really good as well. Doesn't heat up at 300 degrees. No marks. I like it. It's quite decent quality. Okay. Now, let's go back to heating up this chip. This is a very old SD-RAM that I'm pretty much sure it doesn't work anymore. So it's safe to play with it. Nope, not yet. So no, okay. Let's go. Up in power and temps. We don't have much flux left, but hey, it should work. Yep, it did work. So we have the RAM chip off as well. Now, with the remaining flux, let's see if we can heat up and put it back. Huh? No, it's not perfectly seated. Well, I won't be able to seat it with these tweezers. I need a bit better pair of tweezers. And I should fix the board. Okay, I made it. Yep, now it's seated. Very well, as you can see. Leave it to dry a bit. Well, actually it's not very well now. I see it's, yeah, okay, it's further up the board, but nevertheless, yeah, it's hard to film and seat the chip properly. So yeah, we'll consider it a win. like this. It's one pad up, you see. One some pins, the upper pins, they are in the air, and you have pads, three pads down there. So yeah, the gun works, the flux is really nice, I like it, and the mat as well. Going back to the unit, it stopped by itself after we finished with the desoldering. I pick it up, it's gonna go up in temperature very quick, up in temperature, as you can see. So it's already at 344. We put it back, it's gonna go down. It has a magnet in the holder and the chip here that knows when it's when the magnet is closed, and the temperature goes down. It's gonna go to 100 now, and then after a very short period of time, it's gonna go off. It's gonna turn off the fan and the heating. Yep, as I said, turned off, so it doesn't work on and on and on and on. When you don't need it, it can overheat if it doesn't have this protection, and then lots of things can happen, bad things. So this is a good feature. I've seen lots of these, the same kind, like different branding, but the same machine with the cables not detachable, not even the main cable. So yeah, this one for the price is really, really nice, to be honest. Okay guys, so this was my 3-in-1 review. So I'm very happy with my purchases. The flux is very okay, very good, I like it. It melts decently, it doesn't leave nasty residue. Anyway, you can go with some isopropyl alcohol to clean this up. I didn't do it now, so I saved some time. But normally, yeah, you should clean the board with some isopropyl alcohol after finishing your job. So yeah, I really like how these went on. It was pretty easy to take them off, it was pretty easy to put them back. So yeah, overall I think it's a very good machine for its price. This I like as well, it doesn't go yellow at these temperatures, to see it doesn't burn. So yeah, it holds on temperature as it should, the mat for this. Yeah, and I already said I like the flux. So I hope it was useful, this video, and don't forget, like, share, subscribe. It helps me a lot. I hope this video helped you, and see you in the next one. Bye guys.